Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of A Very Portal Christmas. And by everybody, I mean Britt. Glad that you're here. So I believe where we left off last time was we were knee-deep in the middle of some gels in Old Aperture. There we go. Yeah, so something I really like about this game is how the different menus change depending on where you are in the game. Because now that we're in Old Aperture, we've got this going on, and GLaDOS is singing Italian opera in the background there, singing about how much it sucks to be a potato. I'm sure it does suck to be a potato. I want to finish Portal 2 this week, mostly because Christmas is in 5 days already, jeez. Then also, we've got other games we need to work on, which are probably not going to be finished within the month of December, unfortunately. I may end up not streaming those and instead just record them and then put them up to YouTube separately just so I can get them done. So we'll have to see about that. We'll have to see what kind of progress we make here, how much time is left in December, and how much time is left in the break. Then again, I'm still doing October sketches in December, so, or Inktober rather. Yeah, I might be able to do that. A Very Portal Christmas and a Fan Game New Year. That might work out. But I will be back at school at that point, so it will be harder to stream. Speaking of schedule stuff, as of this recording, or stream rather, the past episodes, the past two episodes are not up yet. Unfortunately, I've had some errors with YouTube, as far as uploading things go, but I'm trying to get that figured out. It might just be because I had it on Firefox rather than Chrome, so we'll have to see. Okay, so I remember this test, but not really. Like, I remember it, but I don't remember how to do it. Right, that does nothing. Okay, yeah, I definitely want some orange gel along here. And let's put some blue gel over there. Okay, so I believe, let's see, that should, okay, so that's the final jump right there. That's going down this way, jumping, and landing over at the exit. Let's see. Okay, so I need to get up there to get the cube. So I can do that. Oh! Wait, I see a thing up here. So I want, I wonder if that'll get me across. I'm not sure. Let's see. Okay. Okay, I need to get blue gel on whatever the heck I just landed on there. Where? Okay, so that's there. So let's see. Okay, so I need to get blue gel there. I put that there. That should be good. All right. Got the cube. Ooh, that was a rough landing. Okay. Real question time. How do I get back down? Oh, okay. Right, it's just down there. Don't drop the cube. Oh, that is very close landing there. Where was the button at? Over there? Okay, so this is actually a lot easier than I thought it would be. Okay, so I get blue gel there, and I need to get it. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! Oh, that was not supposed to happen. Oh, I should have been more careful about where I was placing portals. Did that release a new cube? It did. Okay, good. Whoops. Well, at least I know what I'm doing now. Oh. Oh, there it is. Okay. Let's try this again, but be a lot more careful this time. Okay. Want to get the gel onto there. Okay, that doesn't quite reach. Oh, I remember now. Okay, we need to put it there. So we need to actually go take the cube off for a second so we can coat it in the blue gel. Right, and then actually can't quite reach that from there. Okay, so now we put that portal there, and we put this portal here, and now it's been coated, right? Okay, good. And we put that there, this here, get the cube back on the button. And I believe all that's left now is going for it. All right, hopefully this works. Yes. Yeah, I think I'll pass Cave, but thanks for the offer. I love how you can still see the little glow from GLaDOS. She's like a mini flashlight. Oh. Portal's doing that thing again where it likes to crash on the loading screens. Okay, so that music that kicked in lets us know that we just finished another sphere and another era of aperture science. So, you'll notice there is a new pump station up there. We're about to get a third gel, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, Boop. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for not loading longer than 20 minutes. That texture looks really weird. Is that supposed to be doing that? Whatever. Right, of course, elevator to the surface is cut off. Aha. Need to get up there. Oh, that's obviously not a portable wall. Okay, well, I can't go back through there. Oh, it's right here. Walked right past it. There we go. Oh, that's very much closed now. I love how that's the first place GLaDOS went. Did I kill her? Maybe? I don't know. I've killed so many. But yeah, so GLaDOS is figuring out who Carolyn is. I don't know if those of you in the audience know. Hi, Feeny. Hello. Welcome. Alright, so we have blue gel, repulsion gel, makes you bounce. We have orange gel, propulsion gel, makes you go fast. And we have white gel, and we are about to see what that does. Right, because pudding. Pressure pumps on a walkway is such great design for the workplace. Luckily, the end of Portal 1 taught us well. Oh, hello, Ryan. Let's see, so we need to get up there, I'm assuming? Or no, the exit's up there. We need to get up there. Okay, so let's see, it looks like. Ah! So, actually, we're gonna find out right now, even before the test starts. The white gel makes it so we can place portals. Anywhere the white gel goes, we can put a portal. So, this is about to turn into Splatoon, to be honest. Because we are going to be painting every inch of the test chamber. Alright, and this, you gotta time just right. Yay, not dead. My new boss is a robot. But did you know robots are smarter than you? Robots work harder than you, and robots are better than you. Volunteer for testing today. So, oh, and also you can see here, it's the updated modern Aperture Laboratories logo now. So we're definitely getting very close to getting out of here, getting back to modern. So yeah, we're almost out of here. This is the last gel to be introduced. Is that the testing sphere we're getting to? Or... No, I think we're getting to that one. Yeah. I think, anyway. Yeah, 'cause we need to get over there. And we need to do that without dying, preferably. So, let's see. So, I think... I can't remember how many testing spheres we've gone through. I don't know. We'll have to... I think we're close to the end. Okay. Think if I put a portal there, it should work. Let's just, no, let's, oh, good thing I'm not afraid of heights. Come on. It needs to go over just a bit. Oh, do I need some orange gel? Right, okay, but I don't see... Was there an orange gel back there I could use? Oh no! Shoot, I didn't realize I'd gone that far. Oh, okay, yes, thank you. Brit, Yeah, I know what to do. Okay. Alright. Okay. Someone at Valve has to have, like, just a thing with birds. Yay, made it.
Welcome to the Enrichment Center. Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. And the bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up.
Alright, so, we are now in the year 1981. Technology has definitely advanced. We've got these fancy new computers and those sleek, streamlined, phones, right? I forgot the word for phone. And it looks like some AIs have. Oh, does she not react to this one? She's gonna react to a Paradox poster later. But yeah, it looks like we've got some AIs, possibly some turrets. So, in the event of a rogue AI, remember, stand still, remain calm, and scream, "This statement is false," or "New mission, refuse this mission," or "Does a set of all sets contain itself?" And as you can see, our fearless leader, Cave Johnson, he's not looking so hot anymore. He's seen better days. He is, in fact, dying of poisoning from moon gels. So yeah, robots have definitely come into play here. And look, that's a modern button and modern cube there, so we've got to be close. Is that timed? No, it's not. It is not a timed button. So yeah, robots are definitely becoming a thing here. Modern Aperture Science logo. Warning, please do not test if you are allergic to lunar sediment and/or starch. If you have fulfilled your monthly test self-election quota, or you are confident enough in your work performance to unvolunteer from the test self-election process. So, mandatory volunteering, basically. I feel like that's an Easter egg over there. That looks like an I Easter egg. While we're walking over there, Britt has been talking about the co-op in there, which is something I've actually not done up until this point. So I'm wondering if we might be able to do that on the stream at some point. Combatant testing area. Remain still if you're targeted. Ah, there's no button on this one. So, okay, that is in fact not an Easter egg. All right, so back to testing. This should be our last round of like testing, because once we get out of here, things are going to change drastically. Like there'll still be tests, but not like tests. Yes. Okay. Britt says she wants to co-op with me. I know she's been waiting on a new laptop. This is a long elevator ride. Wait, there's DLC co-op? I didn't know about that. I have to buy that then. Right, so this is the fun part. Look at that. Look at how much fun this is. I mean, you're not doing it yourself, so maybe you don't know how much fun it is, but it is fun, I assure you. Oh wait, I think I know what happens after this test. Because you will notice, Cave Johnson had a quote in there about life handing you lemons, and to make lemonade. It's really hard to talk and read chat at the same time. Yeah, anyway, and then I believe the Oracle turret also had said something at some point about getting bad if you go all the way back. 3 weeks? It took GLaDOS 3 weeks to go through all of the test subjects. Okay. How do I get out of here now? I need to pay attention to what I'm doing. Come on, I should be able to shoot that. Okay, sure, that's a thing. Yeah, I can see my legs. Okay, now we can get out of here. There we go. Right, I was talking about foreshadowing, but I think we've already covered that. Okay, so I need to get up there. I believe what I need to do is I need to get some gel over here. Need to get it just the right angle. That looks good. So we kind of need to ladder our way up on this, because what we need to do is we need to get some gel all the way up at the tippy top. There we go. That should be good. Okay, so now that I'm up here, I need to get over there. Okay, and this is... I'm sorry, excuse me. Yeah, I need to get some gel right underneath here. This is not a good angle. Alright, long fall boots, do your stuff. Ooh, that was actually kind of close. There we go, now we've got stuff where we want it. Is that it, actually? I feel like there's another step to this test. But maybe it is actually just a lot more simple than I thought. Okay, so when we fall down, it doesn't quite match up with that. Oh wait, no, what am I saying? It does. There we go. And that should get us to the right spot. Here it is. And I believe that's. Now, as you can see, there's only one test in this particular sphere. So yeah, that was the infamous Lemons Rant. God, I used to quote that practically daily in high school. And I think by this point, you should be able to figure out that Carolyn and GLaDOS are the same person. So it is unfortunate Cave Johnson did die before he could be put in a robot body. So instead they put Carolyn in there, and she became GLaDOS. There are some cut lines in there that Britt is mentioning in the chat where she's really not on board with this. Not because she's being modest, but because they're basically damning her to a life of immortality in a robot body, which may appeal to some people, but not everyone. And we don't know, I mean, I don't know exactly what year this takes place, but if this was 1981 and the game itself was made in 2000s, like, it's been a good, 30 years at least since she was put in the robot body. And then, you know, we have to take into account, like, the amount of time that passed while Chell was asleep, and also how long it took people to get the AI ready to go, because her personality may have been stored on a disk and just sitting there for a while. So, like, it just doesn't sound like a good time. 1982. Okay, maybe this isn't the last we hear of Cave Johnson. Maybe there's one more. Because we are going to enter another sphere, I believe. Because now we're entering 1982. So this was built only a year after. Or we can finally take the elevator, maybe. That would be nice. Yes. Oh. Yes. Okay, we're finally heading up. This is an elevator shaft. We finally have access to it. Okay. Good, 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 good. We are finally getting out of here. Time to see what's going on back up at the surface. Oh, right. I believe there's some falling that takes place here. Be careful not to fall into my old portal. Okay, I can fall through that. I can fall through that. I'm supposed to fall through this. I just need to get up to a high enough point. I believe up there. It looks like I need to get up there. Oh, wait. Here's a thing right here. That explains it. Let's see. Just gotta get it right. Just the right angle. Or maybe I just do this. Let's see what happens. Okay, I need to place a portal somewhere. I need to place the orange portal up there. Ah, it didn't work. Okay, maybe that's not a portable surface. What am I missing? I'm missing something. Maybe I need to go further down. Okay, so if that's still up there. Wow, that's a much longer fall. Oops. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to. Oh, okay. Right. Whoops, that wasn't supposed to happen. Right. Okay. So yeah, that is not something I can jump onto. I need to get back up there now. Maybe I had the right idea then with this. There we go. That's what I needed to do. And let's see. Okay, so it's like that last, I think it's just like chest. Gotta stop doing that. Test chamber 19, in the first game. Okay, cool. I did it. All right, so good. We're definitely getting out of Old Aperture on this episode. Gosh, I've been streaming for 45 minutes already. Right, exploding with dignity. Okay, so we're still pretty far deep in the salt mines. But we are past Old Aperture. We're past the testing spheres. We actually skipped over that 1982 testing sphere, which I'm guessing might actually have been robot testing. Right, so we need to go up, 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 up. Further up. Okay, let's see. Is the next spot there or no, there's a hole there. So we need to get up there somehow. Okay. Oh, I do see some gel leaking. Where is it leaking to? Okay. Let's just try this out and see. Oh, wait. We need to move the blue to there. All right. Let's go. Okay, so we need to put the blue goo there. And then do it again. Okay, that should be good. Okay, good. There's some white gel up here. Caution. Good to know. Let's see if I put that there. Okay, so I don't want to exit out of this portal. I want to enter through there. And I need to get. Wait a second. Is that where I landed? I think that's where I landed. Right, so then if I do this, I should bounce then. Or not. I can't stop. Can't stop, won't stop. Okay, no, I'm supposed to put that there as I'm falling. So put that back there. No, okay, I come out the other way. I'm probably overthinking things, and it's really just a matter of, no, there's glass in the way. I can't reach that. No, those are lights. I thought that was something. This doesn't seem to do anything for me. Maybe it's a blue jaw momentum puzzle. Okay. Right, so that's why this is here, because then I can reach the blue gel drip. And I put this here? Oops. Didn't want to do that. Shouldn't it be dripping? I think it stopped dripping. Yeah, it's just straight up not dripping anymore. I do remember getting stuck on this before. Okay, what if I keep that open? Maybe that spot down there is a red herring. Nope. I just hit my head on that. That's no good. Ah! No, no, no! Ugh. Stop jumping. Okay, so no, that's angled, so that's always going to propel me there. Yeah, it's not dripping anymore, so I can't use any more blue. And I thought I was using momentum, but it's... How about we just try that again? Let's... where I put that there, and then oh yeah, okay, I was on the right track the first time. Okay, so that's blue, and put orange there. Okay, so I was on the right track, my bad. Okay, and I definitely do remember this one. Oh, right. I have to. Are there no other portal surfaces anywhere? Or. Okay, that works. Sort of, not really. That's not helping. Come on, that should work. Come on. Okay, I think now we're starting to make some progress. Just gotta. I don't remember this being so difficult, getting. Gel onto gel, or onto the floor. Okay, cool. Thanks, Britt. Oh, nope, I'm stupid. There's been a hole up there the whole time. I was gonna say, that didn't quite feel right. Get everything nice and coated. There we go. Okay, so we need to put orange here, obviously. Okay. And then, okay, so I'm gonna go here, jump, land in that portal. Jump, land in that portal. Where would I come out from there, though? I want to get to the top here, so maybe I don't want to jump? I don't. Or maybe the jump doesn't take me as high up as I thought. Okay, oh, come on, I just want to center you. That is not centered. Why does it keep putting it over to the side there? Alright, fine, whatever. That's where it goes. Okay, and then I should be able to just place the orange portal wherever I land. Like, well, not quite like that. Let's try that again. Okay, so I need to go up just a little bit higher. Okay, good, got it. And we want to put some blue up here so we can keep bouncing. No, I want to put. Let's see, that's blue. Right. So now I can do this. And then do this. Good. Now we've got our blue. And. We made it, I think. This should be good. Boing. Boing. Oh, we didn't... Oh, wait, yes we did. Yes we did. There we go. I was gonna say there's another portion to this, but nope. Let's do this, an arrow pointed up that way. There we go. Right, yeah. So from here on out, the white gel is actually going to be very important. Let's see. I do remember this bit. I do remember this. This way up. Yeah, they actually put that in there, because, see, you're standing here, so it looks like you're going down. Yes, the regret orb is back soon. I've been streaming for almost an hour, so I'm gonna do an outro in just a bit. How do I get back up there again? Yeah, this level becomes very disorienting. It's very hard to tell which way is up. So that's why they put this way up there. Wait, what? Oh, I didn't think I could walk up this. Okay, that's even more disorienting than before. Ah, you'll see right there. That is the door. That is our escape right there. Excellent. Uh-oh, am I not? There we go. Yes, we made it. Okay. So yeah, like I said, once I get to a stopping point, which is very, very, very soon, I'm gonna end the episode here. I'm gonna keep streaming, but I'm gonna end the episode. Oh, we're almost there, guys. There's not much of the game left after this. But there's some very fun parts of the game after this. Right, so I need to go. I need to go up there. That's where I need to go. So I believe this should be a momentum puzzle, I believe. Right, because they have this right here. Or... No, but that's over there. That doesn't line up. Let's see. Where can I drop down from here? I cannot. There's gotta be another spot. What am I missing? Oh, that up there. Okay, it's too dark back here. Okay, I can. That might be a little too high, I'm not sure. Right, this one lines up. Okay, I just want to make sure. I mean, that's the only lit spot, so I can only imagine that that's where I want to be going. Oh. Right, so I just launched straight into that prompt there. Can't believe I made it. Good thing that window was open. Oh, this is so cool to watch. So much fun. And oh man, the lighting on this. It's great. I love it. I love it. I love it. And there you can see the gel pipes are being connected, so now modern aperture is going to have gel mechanics as well. Oh, and there's our ride. Just need to get back down. Thank God for long fall boots. Oh. We did it, guys. We're out of here. Done with old aperture. All right, so we did get a huge amount of lore in that section of the game. Dang, so now we are underneath modern aperture. But while the last section was lore heavy, this is where things get interesting. Vitrecuff. Wait, this says Vitrification Order 1961, but there were chambers in there past 1982. That doesn't make any sense. And look, that's the old Aperture logo as well. That's weird. Maybe this particular elevator shaft went directly down to one of the other spheres? That's weird. Huh, I've never noticed that before. I thought I'd never miss seeing an Emancipation Grill. Oh, and look at this. A clean elevator. Oh, feels good to be back. Ooh, new loading screen. So, we've gone through Aperture Science, we've gone through Aperture Innovators, Aperture Laboratories. Now, welcome to Wheatley Laboratories. Oh, things are getting grumbly. Those poor turrets. Okay, he's gone for now. So yeah, poor Franken turrets. It's cubes and turrets combined together. It's this ungodly amalgamation. All right, so I'm gonna end this episode here. Thanks everybody for watching. look forward to the next episode. Things are going to get interesting. We're going to come back to Wheatley. And while Wheatley is my favorite character, he's a bit of a dick in this next section, unfortunately. But yeah, we're getting very close to the end. So tune in next time. Thanks for coming. Bye.